guys, welcome back to my channel. So in my previous video, we saw what was the BSS, that is the basic service head, which is a WLAN topology. Now in today's video, let's see what is extended service head, which is the second type of topology which is seen in WLANs. So it is nothing but the just contribution, or when you collaborate multiple BSS, you form an extended service head. And so this is how the architecture, or the way in which the ESS, where clients and APs are arranged. So this is a topology. So you have a distribution system in this, and which connects two different APs at two different locations, and has got some kind of STAs. STAs are nothing but the mobile stations. So especially in WLAN, that is IEEE 802.11, we call the mobile stations, we name it as STA, and this is only in the case of 802.11 and in no other cases. So let's start the understanding of how this topology looks basically is. So it is the interconnection of different BSS, and it's called as the ESS. So in BSS, where you saw this was part of an independent BSS, this was part of an infrastructure BSS. So similar in this case, when you just collaborate different independent and infrastructure BSS, and when you just bring them together, you form an extended service set. So it basically extends the services of WLANs by connecting different BSS, and the identification of BSS is done with the help of an SSID, which is nothing but a 1-32 byte character string, and it does not require any need for client reconfiguration. So that means like you can just put that 1-32 byte character string onto this mobile stations, and you need not do any rebooting or reconfigurations at every time or at regular intervals. But so it is updated every now and then. And so each BSS has got single AP, like you can see, and a pool of different wireless client devices, which are called as STAs, that is mobile stations. So STA stands for stations. Next, by connecting two or more APs, which are connected to the same LAN, it provides a larger coverage, allowing client to move from one AP to another AP and can still be part of that LAN, and this process is called as roaming. And so in the video of handoff strategies, we saw like a mobile user moves from one base station to another base station, the process of handoff starts, and so that process is called roaming in this kind of strategy. And so when client senses a radio signal from the current AP, and if he feels that the signal is getting weaker, then he can find a new AP with a stronger signal. So that is a place where the handoff comes into picture, and so it essentially plays a major role in ESS. So the wireless coverage area, which is created or which is formed by joining two or more APs with the help of a distribution system, is called as the extended service area, which is called as ESA. Now in this, there is a requirement that you have this OSI, that is open systems interconnection model, OSI model, in that you have seven different layers. You have the physical layer, data link layer, then you have the transport layer, session layer, and many layers. So major requirement is that a layer 2, that is the data link layer, in that you have two components, that is logical link control layer. That layer should act as a wireless medium for whichever transfer you do in this kind of ESS, and should also serve as the backbone for the ESS. So any architecture or any framework which you use in order to do the sending or transmitting of the signals, that should have the layer 2, that is the logical link control. So in this kind of setup, as you can see, the APs act as a bridge between the wired and the wireless systems or the wireless LAN. And so in this, you cannot see also that the bridge is there, but it's a kind of virtual picture which it plays. And so it allows STAs on either lines to communicate with each other. So that bridge basically provides a link where you can just move from one service area to another service area without getting your call dropped. And so the distribution service, to comment on it, functions as a connector which links multiple APs to form ESS, which facilitates the mobility. So the distribution service mainly focuses on this AP on each of the service area, and it just connects different BSS, and together it will form the extended service area, and that will in fact provide a larger coverage for the service area, that is ESA. So well, that was all regarding the ESS, that is the extended service set in WLAN topology. So hope you guys enjoyed this. If you found, you got educated watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider to subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.